In our random view, currently we just displayed the name of a movie. But what if we also wanted to display the list of customers who have rented this movie? In our domain model, there may not be a relationship between the movie and customer classes. So we need to pass two different models to this view. One is the movie, the other is the list of customers. But here we have only one model property. So how do we solve this problem? We use a view model. A view model is a model specifically built for a view. It includes any data and rules specific to that view. So let's see a view model in action. First, I'm going to add a customer class to the models folder. Add class, customer. Let's give it a couple of properties. ID and name. Now, we use this models folder purely for our domain classes, like movie, customer, and so on. We put view models in a separate folder. So let's create a new folder, add new folder, view models. And then we add a new class here, random movie view model. So as a convention, we use the view model suffix. This class needs two properties. One is the movie. Note that as I type the movie here, ReSharper automatically added this namespace here. The other property is a list of customers. Now, let's go back to our controller. In the random action, I'm going to quickly create a list of customers. We use the object initialization syntax to add two customer objects here. Customer one and two. Now we create a view model object, random movie view model. Again, ReSharper automatically resolved the namespace. Now let's initialize the movie property and the customers. Okay, so this is our view model. Now instead of sending the movie here, we send the view model. Now look, we have a red underline here. Argument type random movie view model is not assignable to model type movie. So basically, that means in the random view, because the type of the model for this view is the movie, we cannot give it a view model. So we need to change this to random movie view model. Now we have an error here because our view model doesn't have the name property. So we change it to model.movie.name. And you can see here we have access to model.customers. In the next lecture, I will show you how to render the list of customers.